Need to cut a valve into a live water pipe that you cannot turn off or isolate? Today, I'm going to show you how to do it using these Aladdin EasyFit Isolators. We'll show you what you get in the box when you buy one of these products, the different sizes of pipe that you can use these products on, how to actually install them on our little under-sink setup here, before finally almost destroying my marriage by making my wife install it whilst getting rained on by a showerhead. The quicker she installs it, the faster she'll get dry. Finishing off with a customary Plumber Parts song. Remember, all the tools that we use in this video, you can buy on our Amazon store. I hope you enjoy the video, guys. Let's get on with it. And remember to hold tight. Let's get going. Also, learn more about the plumbing in your home using our interactive house. And if you're looking for a plumber to do this work for you, pop over to our website and search Find Your Plumber. Right then, so you've got a bit of a problem. You've got to turn the water off somewhere. For some reason, the stopcock has been tarmacked over or something like that. It doesn't exist anymore. And we're back here. If you haven't followed Plumber Parts before, if you haven't seen any of our videos before, it'd be a great idea for you to hit the subscribe button, obviously, but also check out what we've done under here as well, because I've done loads of videos about how to do the pipework underneath the kitchen sink, and it'll probably help you out. But anyway, we've got this big problem here. What can we do about it? How can we fix it? We've got a product here that is going to do it for us. We're not gonna have to turn the water off. We're not gonna have to have really any kind of real plumbing knowledge whatsoever. And I'm gonna do it in front of you today with this live sink setup. Oh yeah, baby! And it's gonna be absolutely wicked. Thankfully, I did put the bucket down there on the outlet. Why don't we have a look at what's in the box first? Then I'm gonna install it in front of you, step by step, following the instructions, showing you how to do this. We'll have the water running just lightly the whole time while we're doing it. Just like that, so you know that there's no skullduggery going on. But anyway, let's have a look in the box. Let's see what we've got inside one of these EasyFit Isolator packs. See how easy they are to install, and actually install one in front of you now. This is gonna get you out of loads of trouble in the future. Right then guys, so I've got the 22mm one here, and effectively, the 22mm one is exactly the same as the 15mm, it's just everything's bigger, obviously. Anyway, let's have a look in here. So, what we've got, we've got our very important instructions. We just pop that to one side. We've then got our little finishing nylon that we're gonna put on last when we're actually installing the valve. We've also then got our little EasyFit Isolator 15mm toolkit, because the toolkits are different for the different sizes. And inside this, and this is what I really like about it, proper company. We've got our small socket with red and blue indicators on it that I'm going to talk about in a minute. We've got a little screwdriver bit as well that we're going to need. And also, very handily, we've also got an Allen key bit that we're going to need as well. Then we've got the main valve body itself. We're going to have a look at this in more detail in a sec. And then on top of that, we've actually got our valve handles so we can have hot or cold, which is really, really nice that they've thought of doing that. Right then, so this is where we're going to be installing. We've got our problem bit here, a little bit of pipe there. This is where our main is coming in. Now you guys have seen me install all this already when I did a video about this nice little plywood panel here, so I hope you found that really helpful. But this time, there's no stopcock. We're in deep trouble. We need to turn the water off to this house, and we haven't been able to do it yet. Or we need to turn the water off to this service, and we haven't been able to do it. That's why we've gone out and bought one of these kits to do it. Now, the most common one you're probably gonna fit is going to be the 15mm, because most water mains coming in 15mm. But it's handy to know that these guys make one in 22mm, and they also make a 28mm one. And also, there have been times where they've been able to cut valves in at hospitals because they haven't been able to turn the supplies off because it's critical for patients and that sort of thing. And they've been able to cut these supplies in without turning the supply off. So it does have other uses as well. If you need to put a valve in and it's going to a service that cannot be turned off because of someone using it, or it's got some sort of cooling need or anything, you're gonna be able to use one of these to be able to do that. There's never a point at during the installation of these products where you're up against it and time is of the essence, because there's never any water flying out. This is a completely easygoing, like if you read the instructions fully through, in fact, I always say now, read them all the way through from the start to the end, so you've got a full idea about how they work, okay? So let's turn the water on. There we go, a little bit of water just coming through. So first thing you want to do is just check the pipe. Make sure you've got no scores in it. And that goes as well for plastic pipe, because these can fit on more than one type of pipe surface. They don't have to just fit on copper. We can fit these on plastic pipe as well, barrier pipe, stuff like that. So that's really, really cool. What we do first is we just undo each one of these Allen keys and effectively strip the bottom part of the housing away, because that's what we've got to get around the back of the pipe first. So no major issues yet, are there? There we go, the bottom part of the housing is now off. So then we just pop it around the back of the pipe like this, till we're nicely in position, just like that. Next, and very importantly, if you're using an impact driver or any drill, turn the torque to half its torque strength. So we've got 20 as our main torque strength, so I'm going to turn it down to 10. That's going to prevent us from shearing off any threads. The next thing that's really, really important to remember as well is that we tighten up our screws in a certain way. We do 1, 2, 3, and 4, just like this. Also, for a bit of peace of mind, guys, these are fully RAS approved. You get a 10-year warranty on them. They're suitable up to a whopping 16 bar pressure and also 85 degrees C, so it should be all right on your heating system as well. I mean, they're cleverly designed and well engineered as well, making them quick and simple to install. So just to reiterate, guys, go easy here. You can do these up nice and lightly, and if you need to later on, I'd recommend you use a standard hand Allen key just to make sure you don't tighten them up too much. Right then, gang, sorry that camera's in the way, but you know, I want to get a good shot of this. Next thing we do, we load up our little socket. Make sure the battery is fully charged on your drill, and also make sure that you've got it set to max torque, okay? That's what we need to do now. Also, set your drill to low speed. We don't want to move any of these here. We just want to be really careful when we pop our drill over the top of these, just like that. So to reiterate, we're on a low speed. We've got a full battery, and also the drill is set to drill and not anything else. There's no clutch or anything like that. And now we're just going to drill until this red line here lines up with the top of this spindle here. One thing I want to say here as well is when you're drilling in, you're going to feel the pressure increase, but as it removes and crimps up the pipe out of the way and behind the plunger, you'll feel that sort of pressure decrease again. So we're up to that bit now. All we need to do is draw our drill out, nice and easy. Take the collar off. Now, how lucky am I here? We'll see. We'll see if I'm a lucky boy. Oh, that's not bad. Just make sure at this point that this dot here lines up with this little dot here. We can now remove this little pin like so. Push the white cap just up like that. And then just lightly tighten one on, just like that. It doesn't have to be too tight. Pop my valve body on. And now for the moment of truth, everybody. Oh, I just turned the water off. How about that? On, off, on, off. At no point during this demonstration have I gone over and turned the main stopcock off in the corner behind us. I did all of that work just there, just then, and it was really, really easy. I followed the instructions through to the letter, and it's all done. Let's see how my little guinea pig does it. Hi guys, welcome back. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get my darling wife, Emily, to come out here. She's never ever really done any plumbing in her life until today. She's gonna attach the EasyFit Isolator, this beast here, to this pipe here. I mean, it sounds pretty easy, doesn't it? But there will be a small amount of pressure, because while she's trying to install this, she's also going to be getting very wet, because just above her will be this shower head. So I'm gonna ring her now and ask her to come over and do it. She knows she's gonna be on camera today. She's really, really nervous. She doesn't do camera. And I'm gonna ask her, let's see what she says. Well, babe, how's it going, you all right? Good, good. Right, I think I'm ready for you to come over now. Can you, remember when you come over, bring a waterproof with you, and also probably see if you can find that pair of waterproof trousers as well. Okay, all right, good. All right, well, I'll see you soon, all right? Oh yeah, Emily, also, might be a good idea you bring a towel with you, all right? I'll speak to you soon. Bye.
Once my darling wife turned up, it truly was an emotional moment to see her donning a pair of wellies, some waterproof trousers, and also a waterproof jacket. It's almost like she'd seen me do plumbing before. While she was waiting, I turned the water on outside to make sure all that was working okay, and then let her read fully through the instructions as well.
Stand under it, Emily, that's cheap.
She was off to a great start doing the first bit of attaching the valve to the pipework, all the while being dribbled on by lovely cold water.
Hey, I'll do all of them.
Right, so you need to torque it up. Use that, that's your torque there, turn up to 20. That's it, there, that's it, stop.
And yes, I do realise this is the worst thing to do to my drill. Don't worry, it will be getting the old hairdryer and a bit of WD-40 treatment later on.
And then in a sec, what you're going to do is remember what you said about those dots. Yeah? There you go, a little bit of movement there you go, that's it, there, that's fine.
More.
That's fine, that's it, no, that's great.
Remove them up, leave the washer on there.
Yeah. You're cheating by not standing under it. Right, get this. You just got to push that all the way back to the back. That's it. Well done.
For me, often innovation is about products that do exactly what they're supposed to do, but are also really, really easy to fit. And that is the great thing about the EasyFit Isolator valves. But Emily did really, really well here. She read the instructions. She knew what she was supposed to do before she went along and did it. I gave her a couple of little pointers here and there, but really she'd have been absolutely fine doing this on her own. And look at the finished product, a valve that switches on and off, fitted onto a live water supply throughout by my wife. Also, the eagle-eyed among you will notice that Emily fitted hers in the full closed position, which is the right way round, whereas I fitted it in the full open position underneath the sink earlier on in the video. So she got me on that one as well.
All done. Turn it on again, okay? My goodness. All done. Now you can go and dry yourself off. So then guys, all done. One of these beasts fitted. As you can see, Emily, with a little bit of persuasion, got through it in the end. I think sometimes when you don't use your hands all the time, it's just hard to even tighten up a screw. But she did really, really well. Got it switched off and stopped the leak in her own home, effectively. So you can get these in 15, 22, and look at this beast, 28 mil. And that's just the proof there that we've got that full ball there as well. So a really, really good product. Really, really good to use, really easy to install. To be honest, plumbers, DIYers, chippies, electricians, all of you guys should definitely buy one or two of the 15mm and a couple of the 22mm ones to put in your van, just in case you have one of those moments, you know what I mean? So thanks ever so much for watching today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please hit the subscribe button, the like, the comment, and I can hear a wisping bit of music coming through from my patrons right now. The song that's coming up would have been selected by my patrons on the Ale Army live stream that happens at 6:30 on a Thursday evening. So there you go, guys. Thanks ever so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. And remember to hold tight. See you soon. Keep going, keep going.
What are you gonna do, baby, if you gotta leak on the big fat pipe? And there's no stack cock. If you can find the stuck car, and now I know. out there that will help me. Help me fix this leak!
Hey everybody, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Make sure you hit the bell, because you always want to hit the bell when you get a bell in front of you. And also make sure that you visit my vlog, Times of James, and join us for the AL Army, where this song was selected by a group of very sexy people. See you in next week's video, guys. Hold tight.